EA Sports coverage of the National Football League takes us to the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League takes us to the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Cleveland Browns and the Dallas Cowboys. Here's Kai Forbath now to get us started, and we are underway here in Los Angeles. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line.
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Set! 180!
Hey, D-back, let's go! Pick it up!
A first carry now for Nick Chubb. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play at second down.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9.
Alert, 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 alert!
Mike 5-5, Mike 55, Mike 5-5.
I'm coming after you! I'm coming after
Hurry!
Snow!
Check 55 to Mike!
Time to go, night, night!
Out, out, out!
My God! Mayfield looks to throw. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right into a double team, and it's intercepted. And Xavier Woods with a pick. And they're going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. Well, not a good omen there. his first throw of the afternoon, intercepted.
And I know what the fans are thinking right now. I hope there's not negative thoughts in his head going forward since that's his first throw of the game. But one of the things I remember about him coming out of school, he's
a Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 22. Here's Prescott, and the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
They'll put a check mark in the box where the defense coordinator was saying, how well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one, forced the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Frees up your guys elsewhere. So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And it'll be a second and long. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. And there is Amari Cooper, his first catch. It'll be a gain of 15 on the play. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Enough to move the chains.
First and 10 at the 35-yard line.
Check out.
Hey, kill.
Mike. Squeeze, double. Check.
A first down throw for Prescott. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Mac Wilson, the blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8.
Let's go!
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down.
Check. Lucky.
Here's Prescott. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. But for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
Third and long for Prescott. Got it over the man. It's Michael Gallup. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. They get 15, but they still needed a little bit more. Fourth down. And now with the play clock winding down, Jason Garrett opts to take a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it.
He's coming. Double up, double up. He's coming, double up.
We're going to 52.
They're indeed going for it. It's Prescott. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Mac Wilson, and that will force a turnover on downs. So they give it up just on their side of midfield, and yeah, I mean, a surprising decision there to go for that.
Must have a lot of confidence in his defense. Must feel like, hey, we're in great shape here because our defense can hold them because they're really outside of field goal range now, all right, the opposite team. So if you hold them here, you haven't given up any points. You may give up a punt and you're pinned down a little bit, but must have thought it was an okay spot to go for it and decided to be aggressive.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Regular.
Following the interception, Mayfield. He's going to take a shot right away for the end zone. And it's intercepted at the goal line. And Xavier Woods with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold it.
He trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the wild bunch backing me up over here on my own side.
Yeah, we'll see what his offense can do.
First and 10 at the 38-yard line.
Check 31.
Hey, kill. 47.
Get him off. West.
Here we go. 46.
Prescott on first down. Got his man there. Complete to Gallup. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7.
Watch the safety creep. 53 is the mark. 53. Check 53. In your face.
Check the backer. Check the backer.
Kill. 26.
Now Prescott. He's going to find Gallup here complete. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns' 45-yard line.
First down. First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 45-yard line. They'll turn the right side with Elliott. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. No score after 1 on EA Sports. Run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Now the Browns will use the first of their 3 timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter.
Let's go, team. Big series.
Kill.
Mike, 53. Mike. And here we go. Watch the pass. Watch the pass. Check.
Gun.
Throwing on 2nd and 8, Prescott, and this is caught by Witten, the tight end. first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns 18.
As far as tight ends go, this guy's not a speed burner. He's much more of an inline blocking type of a tight end. But how about this last play? Made a nice catch and picked up a first down.
That's what impresses me about him. When he's called upon, usually gets it done. Looking for Cooper, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Denzel Ward. He's at the 50, 30, the 20, 10, 5, and he'll score. Touchdown, Browns.
That was an interception, but on the field, the guys are picking it off. They're not saying that. What word are they using? It's Oskie. That means catch the ball and go the other way.
That's your vernacular. I've never heard anybody say Oskie.
Ask around. They'll tell you.
Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. That's fielded in the end zone. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right? Good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. This will be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Second and three at the 31-yard line.
So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Three down, three down. Check, check.
We're going to 52.
They'll run with Elliott. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
Well, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Prescott down. He's got a man complete. It's Amari Cooper. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Prescott now from the 50. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Christian Kirksey leading the surge there as he drops him for a loss of six. After the sack on first down, Prescott. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Mac Wilson able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon. They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Prescott from the gun. And the pressure gets to him again. Sione Takitaki. The offensive line is in tatters as that's now three sacks in three plays. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Fans fans, a reminder. I have a note card here that says ad lib halftime preview. So I guess let's do just that as we'll hand things over to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando when this one reaches halftime. Did I do okay?
You did great. Not a bad job.
Hey.
But, you know, writing down your ad lib.
If you print, I'm going to read it. I'm Brandon Gaudin. The Browns drive about to get started. And they got themselves a 7-0 lead here, but that, you recall, is a defensive touchdown, so still nothing as of yet for this offense.
Well, they're happy to have the lead. We've got to cut them a little bit of slack. It's still early enough, just a couple of drives so far, but if this one goes nowhere, those adjustments that we talk about, they shouldn't wait for halftime. They should go ahead and start working on them right now.
After the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 20.
Let's go deep.
Here's Mayfield. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The Cowboys going to use their 2nd timeout now, as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important 3rd down. After the sack, they'll come up now 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Let him know. Hurry. Check the alpha.
No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. They'll let it go deep for Beckham. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's 4th down.
Well, one thing's for sure. When you get a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you're going to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. Punt team on now as this one's sent away. Here's Austin. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a 1st and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the 2nd half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes back-to-back. What a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a 2-for-1 without ever even giving up the football. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first? For an offense that has not found the end zone yet, that's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, 1st and 10.
Check 53's mark.
From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Completes it to Jason Witten. Give them 15 there, and the Cowboys have a first.
It's so important to tackle well against these guys, but you and I both know that's easier said than done when the guy you're trying to tackle looks like this guy.
And it's usually going to take more than one man to get him down, and it did right there. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone.
The Browns take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. And with still more than a minute to go in the half, time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity.
He's got the lane, and there he goes. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb, 75 yards. And the Browns have taken the lead. Not a whole lot to recap on that drive. Just one play, 75 yards to the house.
Yeah, it's a long way to go. And remember, rarely is it a straight line 75 yards, too. Got to have a little extra in there. So whatever the final number is, a well-deserved seat on the bench, a little oxygen if he wants it as well.
And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Inside of a minute left in the half. Does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do or, I guess, don't do on this final drive?
It certainly does, but what influences me even more is who I've got running my football team out on the field and the weapons around him. Can he make it?
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Browns defense has a touchdown.
Now that was a beautiful play. A pick six. How would you punctuate something like that, partner?
What do you mean with an exclamation mark?
Exclamation mark, a big word. What would you do with the
ampersand?
I like it.
Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And it's now 21-7. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down, and it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops, and if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially give me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock down and go to the locker room.
The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action.
First and 10 at the 34-yard line.
Prescott now 11-15 through the air. Here's first and 10. Now Prescott. That one complete to Elliott. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
The Cowboys take over first down 10 at their own 22-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. But this is a real, I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of the Jacobs' script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Eight yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two.
Switch up, switch up.
Then we're going to 53.
Prescott. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Check. 53, Mike. Check.
Go, go, go. Get out there, get out there.
Go, D. Let's go.
53 to Mike. 53. Check.
23. To throw is Prescott.
Here we go.
And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. It's a gain of four there that gives him a new set of downs.
53 to Mike. What we got? What we got? What we got?
Mike, 53. 53. Mike.
Under, under.
Here it comes. Here it comes.
26.
First down. Prescott going for the deep ball. And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Cowboys. Amari Cooper, 65 yards. As his guys are back within a single score. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for go, and taken.
Let's go. Let's go.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started, and they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball, but how about them just taking it? Big-time jaunt. Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
Check three, check three.
Shit, shit. My touch. My touch.
They go with Chubb on second down. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Mayfield. Robert Quinn, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9.
Hey, hey, Lord.
Another try after the first down sack. Mayfield, he's got Njoku, his big tight end. And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Switch it.
Run.
And Mayfield just getting the playoff. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Robert Quinn able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
And that's his second sack of the game, but this player, disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it, he's a big-time guy you have to block.
Now Austin. A very good return that time. 18 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
They'll try and get the running game going with Elliott. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. I mean, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Here's Prescott. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Mac Wilson. Who else? He's in there for his fourth sack of the afternoon. Prescott from the gun on third. He's got his target. It's called. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 21 yards there on third down.
First and 10 at the 48-yard line.
All day, every day, any day.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play, so we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll run on first down. It's Elliott. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7.
We own it. Our twist, our twist, our twist, our twist, our twist.
Prescott to throw it. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete. Denzel Ward right there in coverage to get the hand in.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
The Cowboys on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 7.
Here go 47. Mike 29. You ain't going nowhere. 29 is the Mike 29. Get the ball.
26. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. On the left side, Gallup's got it. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about since training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
29 is the Mike 29. 29 is the Mike 29. Here we go, 46. 46.
The Cowboys will go. Prescott. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Eric Murray. And he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line.
Okay, it was fourth down, but you still had time here in the fourth quarter. Instead, they make the decision to go for it on their own side of the field, and this ball winds up getting intercepted.
180!
Check, block 54, block 54. In your face.
A first down throw for Mayfield. He'll find his tight end, Seals Jones. That throw good for four. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Jeff Heath. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. A critical error there in a tight game of the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter. Turning it over, now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter what point, you got to be super careful.
Got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
13 yards and a first down, Cowboys. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. It's a gain of five, and it's a second down. Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down.
You got nothing. You got nothing.
Looking to throw. Prescott. Got his man there, complete to Gallup. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 5 yards on first down, but now just a one-yard pickup there on second.
Hey, kill, kill! Kill, kill! 47!
Mike, 29.
Swear! Swear to the 8! 26!
Throwing, Prescott. And he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup. And he's out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. That's one heck of a third down conversion, a pickup of 39.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Brings up second and 8 at the 8-yard line.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes. And we've got a one-score game. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to... And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, his second touchdown of the afternoon. As they can now tie the game with the extra point here in the final 2 minutes. Critical extra point up and good. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the scores, the kicks away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20.
The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. And three interceptions in this game. I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, what's interesting is what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do.
Partner, they're clearly saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
Hurry, hurry!
Here's Mayfield. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Mayfield and his Browns offense staring at a third and long now after the sack. Touchdown. Here's Seibert now to kick it off. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go into this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Well, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. He looked to throw. And this is caught by Witten, the tight end. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now, as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game. The drive continues as they search for a time touchdown. Here's first and 10.
It's just me and you.
Prescott to throw. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. Credit that breakup to Greedy Williams. Trying to squeeze it in there at this stage of the game. You got to take some chances. Nice job to knock it away, though.
You're so right. Understanding where they are in the game, you got to take that opportunity and maybe thread the needle. Unable to get it done there.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Back to throw. And on the left side, he's got Witten. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Here's Prescott. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
Now, he's been a busy man out of the backfield. They've looked his way quite a bit so far in this game.
Nice job there defensively, though, adjusting, because a couple of his earlier catches, he was wide open. Not that time.
You mentioned the key word, adjustment. A great cover man on him now in space.
And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
We're going to keep getting sacks.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Incredible play there. They do get big yardage, but they're still stopped a yard or two short, and it's fourth down.
It's fourth down.
Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. From Los Angeles, so long, everybody.